Shalom, brothers and sisters. Just want to give an explanation that the video became corrupt. Now I have two broken cameras. I bought one brand new camera, but it's not working properly. So I have to return that one and do better next time. Okay, I'm sorry, but at least I have a backup audio and the camp was pretty decent. Met this brother, and he seemed to accept the truth, man. So hopefully he'll continue in the faith, and you know, repent and come on over. You know, actually spoke to two brothers that night. So, and a sister. We don't know about a sister because I spoke to her before. But hey, it was a pretty decent camp. So, sorry about the video. Just better put the earphones on, man, and rock it. Okay, it's a new song. All right, Shalom.
Action. Hey, brothers and sisters. We made it. We made it out today, man. We made it out today, and I wanna thank the Lord one more time for bringing us out. Bring us out and allowing us to come out and preach the gospel one more time this weekend. So before we go any further, I want to turn to the east and give all honors and praises to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rekakadash. I want to give double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone who bring out the 100% truth and feed the sheep, man. You know, also give a shout out to all the Akim out there that's also believing in 100% truth and doing everything in truth and sincerity, feeding the sheep as they go on about their way through this walk. We're trying to do it. We're trying to do what the Lord has asked us to do, man. So, yeah, brother said right before I came, they were out at camp, and he said, hey, man, if you wake up and we still know, we still have the faith in our head, the Lord is not blown out our candles, consider yourself lucky, man, because as we saw all last week, a couple of weeks now, the sifter has been moving through, and he comes through every so often, and we can just see it happening. So get a little nervous around that time, and things just start happening, but you know, stay strong and stay in the faith. And that's when it's a good idea to examine yourself, like we always say, examine yourself. Make sure that you're in the truth, or you're in the faith. Just check your actions and your thoughts. Make sure they're sound. Make sure they're of the doctrine, man. That's it. Just keep yourself together. Most of all, have faith in the Lord and know that, you know, he's not going to leave us out here. As long as we're doing the right thing and we try to do our very best to do what he said to do. And we have the faith and we believe in him, man. And the Lord say, hey, I'm going to make sure that you're okay. So that's what we should be doing right now. All right, so without further ado, we're just going to go into the scriptures and do the work for the Lord this week, and pray for a better week next week. I don't know. You know, we're just making it through. Yes, hey, good night. All okay. All right. So, hey, everybody. I want to thank y'all for coming out tonight and to listen to this gospel of peace. It's 100% truth of the Bible, because in the last days we have come to realize that we've been lied to up in these churches, man. So in these last days we're coming out here proclaiming the true name of the Lord, which is Yahweh. You good to go, brother? You want me to move it for a little bit? Okay, thanks. We're coming out here to proclaim the true name of the Lord, which is Yahweh. And his son's name is Yahweh Shai. I just got into it with the brother just now, because he still insists on calling on this Jesus Christ, his name of Jesus Christ. But then he say, oh yeah, well, we know he's black. That's true, but are you going to take it? Are you going to leave it there, man? Because as long as you keep calling this so-called fake God and false God named Jesus Christ, that's who you're worshiping, man. You're worshiping a false God and a false idol. Even if you know he's black, his name is Yahweh, and his son's name is Yahweh Shai, man. This Jesus Christ is a false god and a false idol. That's why they depicted him as being a Caucasian man. But we read in the book of Revelation that he's a brown-skinned man. Let's read that right now. This is the book of Revelation, chapter 1, verse 12. And I turned to see the voice that spoke with me. at Bear Turn, I saw 7 golden candlesticks. And in the midst of the 7 candlesticks, one like unto the Son of Man, clothed with a garment down to the foot, and girded about the path with a golden girdle. His head and his hair were white like wool. So he had woolly hair, man. And his eyes were like the flame and his eyes were as a flame of fire, and his feet was like unto fine brass, as if they burned in a furnace. So his feet were the color of fine brass, like our arm, man. Like a brown-skinned African-American. So right there, they let you know you're worshiping a false god and a false idol when you're called upon his name, Jesus Christ, or any other name out there. Whether it be Yeshua, Yah, Rastafari, Selassie, whatever it is. Those are false gods and false idols, man. That's the real name of the Messiah. His name is Yahweh, and his son's name is Yahweh Shai. So how can you have faith and believe in somebody when you don't even know who he is? And you call it upon the wrong name. Where's the faith at then? That's no faith. That's a false god and a false idol who you're calling upon. Alright, so we wanted to make that clear to everybody, because this is what we're doing to come out here and proclaim the truth, man. Hey, brother, good night, man. So we're going to go again to the book of Isaiah chapter 58, where it says, cry aloud. That's right, get out here on the streets where people are coming and going, the G Place of Concord. Not in no church, because the Lord said he's not in no churches built with hands. Because all they're doing is lying to y'all up in there in the first place. He says, cry aloud. Spare not. Don't spare nobody's feelings. Don't sugarcoat nothing. Because we're dealing with your very souls here, man. Anybody got time to be placating you and lollygagging around when it comes to the truth? There's only one truth. But the Lord say, I am the way. There's only one way. You can't get no 8-9 churches from one Bible. That let you know that they lying to y'all up in these churches. Hey, brothers. That let you know they lying to y'all up in these churches. You cannot get no 8-9 different doctrines off of one Bible because they sugarcoating the thing for you. They say, oh, over here in this church, you can do this. Over here, you can do that. That means they're breaking the law, statutes, and commandments of the Lord, and they're not worshiping the one true living power. They're worshiping Jesus Christ, a false god and a false idol, which tell people they can do whatever the hell they want to do. But that's not what the Lord say. That's order. That's why he say he's going to destroy those who is against him when he comes back. And being against the Lord is not taking his word for 100% truth and not doing what he say. That's being against the Lord. That's like breaking up. When if the stop sign says stop and you don't stop, you broke the damn law. So it's the same thing with this. Simple as that. If the stop sign says stop and you don't stop where it says stop, haven't you just broke that law? So it's the same with the scriptures. You can't take what you want and leave the rest. It says, cry aloud, spare not, lift up thy voice like a trumpet, man, and show my people their transgressions. And again, we're going to get down to these lies. Because in the Bible, the Lord has a chosen people, and he specifically just says he's with the house of Jacob, the children of Israel, only. He said they don't really care about the other nations. They're just fluff. They're filler to make the cities move on about. That's what they're going to be for, and they're for slavery for us in the new kingdom. That's it. That's why it says, show my people their transgressions. But again, yet in these churches, they try to include everybody of every nationality up in these churches. And they don't even tell you that you're the children of Israel in the first place. He says, show my people their transgressions. Why does he say show them their transgressions? Because he does not like iniquity. And he wants you to straighten up your act, man, and do things the right way. So he don't have to destroy you, brothers and sisters. That's all. This is the mercy of the Lord right here. Trying to get you together before he comes back, man. That's all it is. And we out here trying to make sure that you know so you can make the choice. Okay? Let's go to the second scripture. We're going to go to the book of John. This is book of John chapter 11. This is the book of John chapter 11 verse 26. Well, let's start at 24. Martha said unto him, I know that he shall rise again in the resurrection at the last day. Yahweh Shai said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life.
he that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. So the Lord said, when you believe in him, it's going to bring you back to life. Because right now, all you brothers and sisters out here that think y'all calling yourselves West Indian, you're calling yourselves African American, you're calling yourselves Native American Indians, you're calling yourself some Cuban or Spanish. You're from the lost 12 tribes of Israel, man. So when you believe in the word and the real true doctrine of the Lord, he's going to bring you back to life. Because right now, you're in the valley of the shadow of death because you don't even know who you are. You're in the valley of the shadow of death because you're breaking all these laws, statutes, commandments. You're not with the one true living God. You're not with Yahweh Shai. You're with this so-called Jesus Christ over here. He says, and whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die, believeth thou this. He said, believe that. He said, who believe in him will never die, because we're working right now for eternal life when the Lord comes back. That's the promise that he made to the children of Israel. That's what we're waiting on, man. That's what we're waiting on, this new kingdom and this new heaven when the Lord comes back to save us from this buffoonery. Look at, listen, people. You got, I don't know what's going on down there. They got two different people. Sound like they're playing two different musics at one time. Confusion. Then you got another ball over here playing some music over there. It's ridiculous, man. Let's go to the book of Revelations, chapter 12. We're going to read that one more time, what the Lord looked like. Because that is believing in him, man. Believing in who? Yahweh Shai. Not believing in this false god named Jesus Christ. We're talking about believing in the true Messiah. Let's jump. Let's go to Revelations 1 and 14. Let's get right to the point. His head and his hair were white like wool, as white as snow. So he had woolly hair, man. Not this whole stringy hair right here that they talking about is so-called Messiah. His head and his hair were white like wool, as white as snow, and his eyes were like a flame of fire. And his feet was like unto fine brass, as if it were burned in a furnace. So if the Messiah had the color, if his color was the fine brass, he's a brown-skinned man. So when you worship this false god named Jesus, this false idol named Jesus Christ, who is a Caucasian man, you're worshiping a false god and a false idol, man. So therefore, how can you believe in the Lord if you're thinking about this other man as your Messiah? That's what we're talking about. Okay? So we got that out of the way. Hopefully everybody understand that. Now let's get to what's going on here. This is 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 3. Because this is the point. So they got you believing in this false god and false idol up in these churches, because they have no god of their own. Because don't forget, the one true living God, the creator of the universe, said, I am the God of who? The God of Israel. Everybody knows this. But no, these people want to lump this up onto our God. Okay? And then have us worship their God, because they have no God. You ever heard of crabs in the barrel? They don't want nobody to win. They don't want you to win, children of Israel, because they know that you're the kings on the queens on the earth, man. They know that once you get your power back, the Lord's going to come back and he's going to put them at the bottom and make them our slaves. And they don't want that to happen to them. Okay? This is the book of 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 3. It says, let no man deceive you. Because a lot of people are waiting on the devil to come back to deceive them. But the devil is already here deceiving you already with this false god and this false idol named Jesus Christ. The real Lord and Savior, his name is Yahweh. Bahashem Yahweh Shai, man. It says, let no man deceive you by any means. For that day shall not come. What day? The day of the Lord's return. That day shall not come except there come a falling away first. The falling away has already happened. It began in 70 AD when the Roman Empire took over Jerusalem. And that's when they start whitewashing all of our images when we used to rule the earth. They put their image in front of our image. That's when they started whitewashing all of our saints and making them white. Or making them Caucasian, should I say. He said, except there come a falling away first. So that began the falling away of us losing our heritage and knowing that we are the children of Israel. Back then, a lot of them became Romans. How you doing, brother?
All right.
A lot of us became Romans, and now, fast forward to this day, a lot of y'all walk around here calling yourselves Americans. Because you don't know that you're the children of Israel, man. You understand? We are the children of Israel. We're the chosen people. A lot of us call ourselves West Indians, Jamaicans, all these other names. It says, except there come a falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed. So the man of sin is being revealed right now. That's what we're doing out here. We're revealing this man of sin. The man of sin is the same nationality of Greek, this group of people that whitewashed our image back in Jerusalem and put this false god and false idol into play here named Jesus Christ. Well, we just read what he looks like, but they're saying that he looks like somebody else. Huh? It says, until that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition. So, this marks that the Lord is about to return. And that's why we're coming out here, letting y'all know what's going on. Because it just says, let no man deceive you, for that day shall not come. What day? The return of the Lord, except there come a falling away first, which already happened. And that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition. That man of sin is being revealed right now. So that in turn lets us know that our salvation is closer than what we believe, man. Because the man of sin has been revealed. And we're understanding now that we had to fall away. Hey, brother, if you want more information, you know about the children of Israel and everything, right? You know about the children of Israel? You believe in the Lord and stuff?
Yeah, I believe in
the Lord. We're out here, man, to proclaim that the Bible is 100% true, right? But what has happened? That these people, you see all these gods here?
Yeah.
That's Buddha. And these are all from other nations. All the other nations, they got their own gods, right? Because there's only one true living God. Everybody knows that. So they don't have a God. That's why they have all these false idols, right? And the Lord say to the children of Israel, make sure that you keep yourself separate from these people and don't worship their gods. That's what he's saying. All these other nations do not worship their God. I'm your God. That's what he's telling the children of Israel. So, if all the other nations have their own God, where's our God? Our God is invisible. You eat what I'm seeing. But what's happened, that these people, the Caucasian race, this is their God. Yeah, I've been doing it forever. Remember, we talked before.
Everybody in the study for me.
I can't stop. This is the ordained by the Lord. He says, we got to do this until we come back. We're going to be in some serious trouble. We're spreading the true gospel, telling people to repent and get themselves together. Believe in the one true living God. Not this false God no more, man. Because things about to happen here. You see what happened in Bahamas? That's judgment from the Lord. And that's going to get worse and worse and worse. Okay? Because he's coming back judging the people. And anybody that don't believe, that keep believing in him, and not believe in the real God, which is a brown-skinned man, who say that, hey, I don't care about these other nations. I only care about you, children of Israel. Anybody that has not been reborn, so to speak, the real rebirth. He said, I'm going to get rid of y'all. Huh? That's like 2,000 people dead in the Bahamas. Don't believe that stuff when they're telling them. I'm talking about some 50 people. Uh-uh. And it's going to get worse. So we got that.
Well, who do you just like tonight?
The Lord. Let me read it to you. This is a book of Revelation, chapter 1, verse 12. And I turned to see the voice that spoke with me. And being turned, I saw seven golden candlesticks. And in the midst of the seven candlesticks, one like the Son of Man, which is the Messiah, clothed with a garment down to the foot. Now this could be a little longer. And girdle about the paps. This is a girdle about the paps. And girdle about the paps with the golden girdle right here. So this is what he wore. This is what our forefathers wore. These are some of the paintings back in Jerusalem. Because we used to rule the world back then. We were kings and queens. These are called the Dark Ages. These are things they didn't want you to see. They don't want you to know about these things. And they came when the Roman Empire took over Jerusalem. That's also in the Bible. They came and they started to whitewash our images, man. And they tried to forget all about this. Because look, this man is under him. That's the Roman Empire coming, learning about our God. So they took that and turned it into Christianity. See? That's what happened. So we're coming out here letting everybody know the truth, man. The absolute truth about all the lies. Because in the Bible it says, hey, be holy. The Bible's only written to the children of Israel, not these other heathen nations. But other heathens are the other nations, all of them. Like I was telling the brother right now, all the other nations have their own God, including the white man. And they put their God in front of our God. And they told us that's our God. So they're using the Bible and everything. They changed the name, but the Bible is still true. But what they did, they put their image up. So they got everybody worshiping this man as God, which is what? Breaking one of the Ten Commandments. They have to have no other gods before me, right? And for having people wear all these crosses and idols and stuff like that, that's the fourth commandment. Don't do that. You know what I'm saying? Because they got the children in the midst of sin. As long as they have the children in the midst of sin, the Lord is not going to take care of them. Now, that's scriptures in the Bible, in like 2 Chronicles chapter 19. I read that to you. Remember how I read when the Lord had all those nations come and kill each other for the children of Israel, man? And remember what he did to the Egyptians, man? You know what I'm saying? And so they don't want us to know this. That's why they feed them lies in these churches saying that everybody can make it into heaven. That's not true. It's only for the children of Israel. And by far, even the elect of the children of Israel. Because a lot, the Lord said two-thirds of the people are not going to believe this. They're not going to change. They're not going to want the truth. They're going to keep worshiping this false God until he comes back, and this is going to kill them. So that's what we're doing out here, warning the people. Because what's going to happen now, the Lord's sending these plagues up on to America, just like he did Egypt. There's going to be famine. He's going to be starving. He said people are going to starve to death so bad they're going to start eating their little babies. That's how bad it's going to be. And that happened before in Jerusalem. There's going to be martial law, okay, when all these outbreaks start happening. They're trying to push that right now. That's why you see people in Hong Kong, in Paris, all these in Venezuela, all these uproars, and that's going to happen all over the place. When you see all these things happening, no, it's close. That's when it's going to mark off. That's going to kick off martial law. Alright? They're going to start killing the children of Israel like nobody's business, just like that. Then they're going to try to implement the mark of the beast, which is the RIF chip. Don't get that. That's why it says in the Bible, he that buys, you can't buy or sell without that chip here. That's what's going to come. So do not get, you'd be better off starving to death than to get that thing, okay? I'm not lying. So when you see these things happening, no, our salvation is close at hand. That's what we out here. That's why he's got us out here. I'm not the only one. There's brothers on Tortola, St. Thomas, St. Croix, all around the world. Germany, in Africa, in the United States, all over the world.
So y'all connect to each other?
No, not really. I mean, we feed each other. It's called feeding the sheep. So I'm videotaping this now, see? I'm going to put this online. I have a channel. I'm going to give you my channel on YouTube. And what you're supposed to do now is he said meditate in the word. So once you believe this, you start listening to the word. Listen to the word. You get your Bible and you start studying and you figure out what the Lord really wants you to do. What are you supposed to do? And the Spirit will start talking to you, man. When you repent, the Lord's gonna help you. Man, and you're gonna forget all about the cares of this world, all this madness. It ain't gonna be easy, but it's better than this. And you know, you gotta know you have the salvation in you. All you're going to want to do is do the right thing. You know what I'm saying? It's beautiful. So the brothers, we edify each other. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to just sit around and listen to myself read the scripture all the time. So I listen to another brother read. And I learn from him the words coming out of his mouth are the words of the Lord. Because we're reading from the Bible. And this is the new song. Because in Revelation it said they would sing a new song. This is that new song. The new song is a song of truth. Denouncing these lies that we've been told to. That's a new song. That's why it never gets old. It never gets old because we're out here trying to make sure that people know this. 144,000 and the one-third. He said the two-thirds are not going to believe it. They're going to get healed. See, because the last time we talked, did you do anything? Did you go anything, any place after that? You just went right back in the world. Me and that brother over there was talking just recently about sowing the seed. Because I'm sowing seeds we're talking about now. Some seeds are set on stony ground. Some in sand. And some on good ground. Now the seeds that's sown on good ground, see what we're doing right now, brother? The seeds on good ground are the ones that got to take root and grow. See, because the last time I spoke to you, it would have behooved you to have taken one of these and start watching these YouTube channels and start studying the Bible. Then, when I see you now, you'll be a whole different person. And that's how it is. That's all it is. So either you're going to believe it and go from there and move on and get closer and closer to the Lord,
or you're gonna be like, oh, whatever, Nazini, you know, I learned some stuff. And then you're gonna go right back out in the world, keep doing the same thing you've been doing for the whole life. And one day, the Lord come back, like a thief in the night, like he said he is. He's gonna say, oh, shit! Too late now. Too late to repent. Because the doors of repentance are open now. And that's why we're out here. This is the hands of the Lord saying, come, come. I don't wanna have to fuck y'all up. Come. He said, come, repent, change now. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to have to fuck y'all up. That's what the Lord's saying. You know what I'm saying? Don't say some serious business, man. Yeah. It's going to get ugly out here. Okay? See, she offended by the word. But sometimes you can't. All right. I'm going to write on the back line, okay? Because I have a 1-2. So this is what we're going here. You're going to type in great. Type in great. A bunch of videos from all over the world. And if you want, you'll learn more how to dance better. And if you have a question, just type in Great Hill Song. Just type in Jesus Christ. And you'll watch them, and they're going to come up there and they'll break down a lot of stuff, man.
So you said we are the children of Israel. Even though we were born like in the islands and stuff, or in America, or where we were born.
Yeah, I'm gonna show you. I'll show you. Because what happened is we stood. Okay, that's mine right here on YouTube too. Preacher of Hope. Okay. On because the Lord said we stood in front of Moses. Remember when Moses came down with the Ten Commandments? The Lord said, "Listen, you're my children." And what let you know right there? Who was there? It was the people that he took out of Egypt. Why weren't the Egyptians there? Where was the Japanese people? Where were the Chinese people? It was nobody else but the children of Israel. You know why? Because we're his chosen people. He destroyed the Egyptians for that, man. And that let you know right there. So he said, listen, if y'all do these commandments, I'm going to set you high above everybody. And you know, you're gonna be my people. But if you don't do these things, I'm going to put these curses on you, man. And one of the curses was that we would be scattered all over the world and go into slavery. That was one of the curses. That's how we know. He said, these curses are going to be on you for a sign, and that's how we would know that we are the children of Israel. It's in Deuteronomy. I'll read it for you real quick.
So let me ask you something. So now, you get all these different nations, right? So those nations doing the wrong thing.
Not necessarily. But see, the Lord, all these nations had us in captivity at one point. So we were slaves under all these nations at one point or another.
Yeah?
Yeah, man. Throughout history.
You were Spanish?
We built the Great Wall of China. They won't let you know that. We were slaves. You know? So things like that. And so they don't have the law, statute, commandment. But what the Lord did give them is common sense. They know that they know right from wrong. So there's a certain thing that you should be doing. You should be cheating on another man, taking his wife and stuff. You know, stuff like that. So even though they didn't get the law, statute, commandment, the Lord's still going to judge them slightly about something. And they're going to be our slaves in the new kingdom. So that's going to be the nice thing about it. You know, it's going to be nice. So that's our punishment. That's why. Let me read that for you, because I want you to see that. I want you to see that in Deuteronomy.
So this is something that you just started, or you've been doing it for a little while, or?
I learned about the truth, like on that paper I gave you, the top paper.
Yeah.
On the top is something called Black History, Hidden Identity. A long time ago, what was it? A year and a half ago, maybe 2 years ago. I just, in the back of my mind, I knew something was going on. I don't know what it was, but I said, Lord. I said, let us all become clean in 2017. And I said, Lord, be clean. Show me the truth. Show me the truth. Because I knew, I just felt like something was wrong. And lo and behold, that's when he sent me. Somehow, because the Lord directs your footsteps. So he had me find on YouTube, that's why I put on that, Black History, Hidden Identity. And that man went into Deuteronomy and he showed us. He said, listen,
back in school, they always tell you about the history of black people, but they always start right there at the slave trade. They don't go back no farther.
Yeah, yeah, we saw this.
You know? Hey, y'all are just black people, and we got you from Africa. That's why a lot of people say go back to Africa. But they don't tell us, and like their brother, you don't see it, like their brother say, yes, that is true, we were on the west coast of Africa, but we came from Jerusalem. When the Roman Empire came in, the Lord said, y'all better get to the hills and get, because these people are going to come and kill y'all. So a lot of us ran all over the place. Down in South Africa, some of us, and the majority of us, ran into the west coast of Africa. That's when the Africans helped. They started to help these Caucasian people, and they rounded us up and started selling us into slavery there. So we are not African. And actually, the African people we're the Israelites. We're a different nation. It says on the Bible, it says you're different. He made us different from the Africans, something like that. And the African people has actually came on YouTube and apologized to us. You can find it on YouTube. The African nation say, we're sorry for selling y'all in slavery. That's what they say. Because they know the Lord's coming back and gonna judge them, man. So that's where it begins. So they start black history right there because they want you to think.
Yeah, we start black history, you're right.
They want you to think that you're African.
That's something to think about. Like you say, like when you think about black history, the first thing we learn is about slavery. But
exactly.
We don't learn about the life before slavery.
Exactly. Because they don't want you to know. You see the picture I just showed y'all with the Dark Ages? They don't want you to know that. They don't want you to know that you were the kings and queens on the earth before those times. See? They don't want you to know that. So they want you to believe that you're some nation in Africa. Where? We don't know. Because if that was the case, they would say, hey, y'all come back. The slavery's over. Come back home. Ain't nobody said that, right? Because we're not supposed to, because we're not African. We're in, we are Israelite. And the book of Ezekiel tells us that. The Lord, okay, who are those people in Israel now? Who they call themselves? The Jews, right? Watch this. This is Revelation.
So how about like Arabs and Jews and them people there?
I'm about to read right there what the Lord is saying about the Jews right now. This is Revelation chapter 2, verse 3. It says, I know thy works and thy tribulations, right? Because we work hard. He's talking about us. I know thy works and thy tribulations and poverty. We're poor, but thou art rich. He said, we're rich. Because we have the promise of the salvation of the kingdom of heaven. You know, where we're going to have everything. We're going to be kings and queens again. He said, and I know the blasphemy, the lies of them that say they are Jews, because we're not saying we're Jews. We weren't. We were African American. We were West Indian. But those people over there saying they're Jews. They're saying they're Jewish. But I know the blasphemy, the lies of them that say they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan. Because they're the devil. Devil just means deceiver. Devil just means liar. So those people here, these Caucasian race of people, they are liars, man. Because they lie. First they tell us that that's the Lord and Savior. That's a lie. Then they tell us that they are the children of Israel. That's a lie. You know what I'm saying? Now check this out. This is Revelation chapter 3, verse 9. It says, behold, I will make them the synagogue of Satan, the same people. Don't mind him, man. I will make them the synagogue of Satan, which say they are Jews and are not, but do lie. It says, I will make them to come and worship before thy feet, man. He's Trump. Don't worry about it. He comes by every week talking to himself. He said, behold, I will make them come and worship before thy feet and to know that I have loved thee. See? He said he's going to make them same people over there that done stooped, that have stole our heritage and stole our land, and saying that they're us, he's going to make them come and worship before our feet, man. And that's a beautiful thing, man. That's when I heard this, I was so happy, man.
So we're from Jerusalem. What made us run to Africa?
I'll show you right here.
You said that people were coming.
Because we broke the law, statutes, and commandments of the Lord. And he said this.
Oh, so like a punishment or something?
It's a punishment. And we're still under the curses now. We're still in punishment now. That's why you see a lot of brothers, like some of the punishment, some of these curses. You got a Bible?
Yeah.
Look, read the chapter of Deuteronomy. Read the whole thing, okay?
and you'll see the curses. Some of those curses are, they say, the Lord say, people will get very high above you, and you will become very low. So that's why all these Arabs and stuff that move into our community, what they do? They get a store, just like that, and they come very high above us, and we're still in the same place. We're working for them now, but it's our community. We can't open no store. Why? Because it's one of the curses, man. You see how many people broke up and stuff? All these relationships? That's one of the curses. You see our women? They go out and get jobs, and then they want to be better than the man. They want to tell the man what to do. That's one of the curses. The woman's going to get very high above.
So a lot of our regular lifestyle is curses.
Everything. We're cursed, man. We're cursed. That's why it's very important for us to understand this knowledge, turn, and come back to the law, statutes, commandments of the Lord, so we can be saved when he come back. You know, as simple as that. I mean, it's a beautiful thing, man. I mean, to live. Because look, this is one of the curses here. Women should not be wearing pants. But if you tell a woman that, they don't care. They're going to do it anyway. What's they doing? They're going against the law of the Lord. Simple as that. Tell a brother they're not supposed to shave his beard and stuff. You're not supposed to get lineups on your head and all that stuff. They'll do it anyway. Why? Because they don't care what the Lord says. That's why he put these curses on them. Let me read this 28. This is Deuteronomy 28, 60. Let's do it 45 first. I'm going to tell you about these curses. It says, moreover, all these curses shall come upon thee and shall pursue thee and overtake thee until thou art destroyed. We are destroyed now because we don't know who we are. And it says, because thou hearkenest not unto the voice of the Lord thy God to keep his commandments and his statutes which he commanded thee. Because we didn't do his law, statutes, commandments. He says so. And they shall be upon thee for a sign, and for a wonder, and upon thy seed forever. And they're going to be upon children, and upon their children forever. And they're going to be a sign. So that way we know that we are the children of Israel because of these curses. Ain't nobody else cursed like we are. Who else getting shot in the back by the cops? And then the cop be like, I was scared. And they said, go ahead, sir. No punishment necessary for you. You were scared. We understand. Even though the man didn't have no gun in his hand, he running from you. That's a curse on the children of Israel. Okay? That's what it is, man. And let's read Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 7 real quick. No, 7, verse 6. It says, for thou art a holy people. Holy means separate. Because we're supposed to be separate from the other nations. So when they say segregation, they were right, man. We were supposed to be separate from them. But leave it all to good old Martin Luther King. He's going against the will of the Lord. He's the one talking about something. I have a dream. And Martin Luther King's in his Bible too, man, believe it or not. He's the one that's saying he had a dream that white boys and black girls should be holding hands and stuff. But the Lord said no. He said, for thou art a holy people. Holy means separate. Stay away from these people and keep the law, statutes, and commandments. Because the other nations don't have the law. They don't have to do the law, statutes, and commandments. So they're going to lead the children of Israel astray. They're gonna teach the women to wear pants. They're going to teach the women about women's liberation and stuff and go against the man. That's why he's saying keep yourself separate. They're going to tell everybody to eat crab, shrimp, pork, and lobster. That's the Lord said don't do that. You know what I'm saying? That's why he's saying, for thou art holy people unto the Lord thy God. Here we go. This is the good part. The Lord thy God has chosen thee to be a special people unto himself. He chose us to be a special people, man. Above all people that are upon the face of the earth. Above all these other nations. So when these nations talk about them, they're better than you and stuff, they liars. The Lord said, we are above them. Why do you think that's why?
So let me ask you something. Is there a controversy right now with certain Bibles and certain informations in the Bible, like people alter the Bibles and stuff like that?
No. What they did, see, you got to think about it this way. This is the creator of the universe, my man. So the Lord actually, he controls everything, believe it or not. He just want this thing to play out so he can watch it. He's watching us right now. You know? So he's not going to let them mess around with the scriptures that much, because this is what we need. This is the comforter. This is information for the children of Israel. He did allow them to change the name to Jesus Christ. But this is the Lord's name right now. Right here. I'm going to show you this here. I had to pay $50 for this Bible. Is this the one? I got it, man, because I'm glad I did, too. I don't use it because the words are so small, but I use it to show the name because it's got the real name of the Lord. Because back, don't forget now, the letter J was not introduced until, I think, 1681, right? So this was these words were written in Hebrew. They didn't have the letter J back there. So there it goes again. The J goes with that same Caucasian man, and we know what the Lord looks like. He's brown skin. So when you say Jesus Christ, that's not the name of the Lord at all. So they definitely got the people messed up, man, all everywhere, on every side, man. You know what I'm saying? That's why it's important. That's why the Lord got us coming out here preaching this true word to let the people know. So when you were asking about the Bible, make sure you get a King James 1611, though. Okay.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, okay, they have to be a King James.
Yeah, because some of those other Bibles, they are trying to change the words and stuff a little bit. The wording, try to, so it's not that different meaning. I'm looking for Genesis. I can't see. Oh.
There it is. Look. See? That's the original Hebrew right above it. And the name is Yahweh. See? Because this is when Moses appeared. When Moses was talking to the Lord, Moses said, "Well, who should I say? Who should I tell him sent me?" And the Lord said, "Tell him I am." And it translates to Yahweh. See? That is the Lord's actual name. And the Messiah's name is Yahweh Shai. Remember that, brother. You'll see it when you watch the video. And that's very important because the Lord say, "In your day of trouble, you will call on my name." So that means we have to know the name. So a lot of people think the name is not that important, or they think it's not that important that the Lord, that we think of the Lord as this Jesus Christ. These are important things, man. Okay? So Jesus Christ is like the false name.
It's a false God.
That's like the white God.
Exactly. It's for the white people. It's for their nation. Because, and you'll see on my video, on Creature of Hope, I've had several white people come up here, and we talk. I tell them the scriptures and stuff, and you know what they always say? No, no, no. It's the God is spiritual. He's spiritual. Because they don't give a damn about the actual words of the book. Because they want to do exactly what they want to do. Because they have a la-la land. They created this false God, which tells them they can do anything. And God is all love. But God is not all love. He said, "I'm a God of war." You know, the Lord of hosts. Host means armies. The Lord of armies, man. So when you're coming back, that's why he's coming back. That's why he's excited about coming back and putting a foot off in these people's ass. In the Valley of Jehoshaphat, man. All the nations. He's going to have all the nations fighting. And I was watching this morning. You know the UFOs? Those are his armies, man.
How you feel about the UFOs?
Those are angels. Those are the Lord's angels. Those are his armies. That's who he's going to use to come back.
So you think they exist out there?
Yes! I see them all the time. I got one on my phone. See that? See it? That's the sun right there. You see that? That's in the daytime. That's over by Ram's Head. I didn't try to take this picture on purpose. We got to the top of the Ram's Head, and I was just taking a picture like this, click, 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 so I could show it to my sisters. And 2 weeks later, my little daughter said, "Daddy, what's that?" And I'm like, "Whoa, man!" And right now, let me see if I can bring this up.
But I want to get into the black history.
Well, check out that black history, hidden identity, and then go from there. And then, see this. Look, there's another, this is a live camp right here. So these brothers preaching the same word that I'm preaching right here. And that's what you're going to find on YouTube. All they're doing is standing on the corner, just like I'm doing, in big cities all around the world, doing the same thing, letting people know what time it is, man. Okay? This thing is beautiful. Okay, because the Lord coming back. And you know, it's good because it's real, man. I'm going to show you something else real quick. So this is my channel, Creature of Hope, okay? Watch this. Have you seen this? Everybody, they're going to try to hide this sooner or later. I'm going to skip it. We're talking about UFOs now. This happened.
So Yahweh
and Yahweh Shai is the Messiah. Yahweh is the Father. Yahweh Shai is the Son. You see that UFO right there? This is in Iran.
the military shooting at that UFO. This just happened over the weekend, last weekend.
That's crazy, man. But anyway, man, what's
wait,
your
wait,
name?
Wait, 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 wait. I'm Tommy.
Tommy.
That's really your Tommy. What's your name?
I'm Ryan, but I live in St. Thomas.
Okay. Yes, sir. That's brothers over in St. Thomas, too, around 4 o'clock at 2-2 Mall. They do the same thing.
Okay? Yeah.
You see? Wait, wait, wait. I want you to see this. I didn't know I was talking that damn much. No, I'm talking about on this video. I should have just played the video first. Come on, man.
Because I was like...
This song is like a one-man video. Go! Come on, man. There it is. See them trying to shoot it? See it? See it? It's just fucking with them. It's playing with them. That's the Lord, man. Letting them know y'all better get ready. Because I'm coming back to get y'all for what y'all done did to the children of Israel, man. Look, look. You see that, right? That's real, right? Huh? All right, Ryan. All praise to Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shah, huh? Okay, y'all, we're gonna continue. I think we were at 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 3. This is 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 3. It says, let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come, except there come a falling away, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition. Excuse me, brothers. Now, we already know, we already covered this. The man of sin is being revealed right now, which is these, the Edomites, man. The Caucasian race. Because they run around here lying about who the children of Israel is. And they put their false god up in front of our face, telling us to worship this false god and false idol named Jesus Christ. It says, and this is how you know further that this is true. It says, who opposes and exalts himself above all that is called God. And these people oppose everything that the Lord stands for. Now, they pretend like they believe the Lord and love the Lord, but they really don't. Because the Lord said, hey, he don't like no sodomites and gay people. They say, hey, you can be gay. In fact, you can get married. That's just one example, man. But the Lord said he don't like that. The Lord said don't follow no pagan holidays. And, you know, and do all these things. But they say, hey, we can celebrate Christmas, Easter, and all these things. So therefore, they're in total contrary. They're going against the word of the Lord. So it says, who opposes and exalts himself above all that is called God. And why do we say this? Because they are in control of this country. They're in control of the world. Because the Lord has given the world to the hands of the wicked. So they're controlling everything. So they create the narrative now. So it's their fault that the world is in this terrible shape that it's in. And it is full of sin. Why? Because they're the devil. They are antichrist. They go against the word of the Lord. It says, who opposes and exalts himself above all that is called God, or that is worshipped, so that he... as God sitteth in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. And that's what they done did with this so-called false god and false idol named Jesus Christ. They put that man in the place of God, saying that he is God. But we just read what the Messiah looks like. He's a brown-skinned man with woolly hair. He's not that man there. And his name is not Jesus Christ. It's Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, baby. Let's read that one more time. Because these people... opposes and exalts himself above all that is called God, or that is worship, so that he, as God, sitteth in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. It says, remember ye not that when I was yet with you, I told you these things? It says, and now ye know that withholding, that he might be revealed in this time.
That's right. That's why we're coming out here revealing the truth of the Bible. It says, for the mystery of iniquity does already work. Only he who now let it will let until he be taken out of the way. And the Lord said he's letting these people run their course. Because the prophecy must be fulfilled until the Lord, until that time has come, the Lord's going to come. And he's going to put his foot off in somebody's butt for what he's going to do to the children of Israel and going against his words, man. Let's go to the book of Revelation, chapter 13, verse 4. I hope we got enough film, battery power. But that was fun. That was nice talking to the brother, right? He said his name was Ryan. Okay, there's a book of Revelation, chapter 13, verse 4. It says, and they worshiped the dragon, which gave power unto the beast. And they worshiped the beast, saying, who is like unto the beast? Who is able to make war with him? And this beast, we have come to learn, is this system, man. This same system that says, you know, you can do whatever you want. The laws, the statutes, the commandments are done away with. They're controlling the earth right now. They're putting women above the men. They're telling women they can wear pants instead of dresses. They're going against everything that the Lord say to do. That's the system. That is the beast. And there was given unto him a mouth speaking great things and blasphemies. And power was given unto him to continue 42 months. And he opened his mouth and blasphemed against Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai to blaspheme his name. Then they put up this so-called Jesus Christ to blaspheme the name of the Lord even more. And his tabernacle and them that dwell in heaven. So he done defamed us. They done lied to us and got us going off. Got us committing all these sins and iniquities. And it was given unto him to make war with the saints and to overcome them. And power was given him under all kindreds and tongues and nations. So he's given the power to make war with the saints. That is the children of Israel. That's why he shoot us in the back. And they don't hold themselves accountable. That's why they're doing that to the Bohemians over there. Talking about they can't come, even though their place is all devastated. He's telling them they can't come to the United States for safety. That's why they try to take over Venezuela. For their resources, man. And power was given him over all kindreds and tongues and nations. And that's why this system has spilled over to all the other nations. That's why you got the so-called Chinese man and the Japanese man wearing three-piece suits. Where's your tradition, Chinese man and Japanese man? Where's your beautiful garments that you used to wear? And all that dwell upon the earth shall worship him, whose names are not written in the book of life. So all you two-thirds, brothers and sisters, that don't want to bow down to Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, you want to keep worshiping this so-called false god or false idol named Jesus Christ, your name will not be written in the book of life. It says, and all that dwell upon the earth shall worship him, whose names are not written in the book of life. Because we're not worshiping that false god and false idol no more. We're worshiping the true God and Messiah, Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai. Y'all keep on worshiping that false god named Jesus Christ if you want to. It says, if any man have an ear, let him hear. And it goes on. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. And who led the children of Israel into captivity? Them Caucasian people. That's who did it. And they're going to pay for what they did. It says, he that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. Here's the patience and faith of the saints, man. And these are our patience and our faith because we have faith in the Lord to do what he said he's going to do, which is come back to save the children of Israel out of this hellhole. Let's go to Revelation chapter 19. This is the book of Revelation chapter 19, verse 1. It says, and after these things, I heard a great voice of much people in heaven saying, hallelujah, salvation and glory and honor and power unto Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai. It says, for truth and righteousness are his judgments, for he has judged the great whore, which did corrupt the earth with her fornication. The great whore is them running around out here telling y'all that to worship this false god named Jesus Christ. And hath avenged the blood of his servants at her hand. That's right, because like I just said, he's going to come and put his foot up somebody's butt that what they done did to the children of Israel. So he avenged the servants. And again, they said, hallelujah. And her smoke rose up forever and ever. That's what's going to happen to America. The Lord's going to rain down those nuclear firearms upon this place and destroy this wicked place. Excuse me 1 second, brother. That's a little bit better. Yes, I. Let's go to the book of, in the Apocrypha, let's go to the book of Ecclesiastes real quick. This is the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 15, verse 13. It says, the sinner shall not escape with his spoils, and the patience of the godly shall not be frustrated. It says, make way for every work of mercy, for every man shall find according to his works. That's why we got to repent now and start doing the right thing, man, to build up them riches in heaven, to do the right thing, brother. It says the Lord hardened Pharaoh that he should not know him, that his powerful works might be known to the world. So the Lord did all those things to Pharaoh to make him say, to deny the Father's word. No, I'm not going to let y'all go. Just so he could show his power to the world, man. To let y'all know that the Lord don't play. It says, his mercy is manifest to every creature, and he has separated his light from the darkness with an adamant. So right now we're separating this light from the darkness, the light of the true gospel of peace right here, against that wicked gospel of destruction that they preach you in these churches with this so-called false god and false idol named Jesus Christ. They even got churches where gay people can get married in, man. What? On the back of the money, talking about in God we trust. It says, say not thou, I will hide myself from the Lord. Shall any remember me from above? I shall not be remembered among so many people, for what is my soul among such an infinite number of creatures? It says, behold, the heaven and the heaven of heavens, the deep and the earth, and all that therein is, shall be moved when he shall visit. That's why we're saying the time is at hand, the Lord is coming back to visit the earth. Did you see that storm sit on the Bahamas like that? That's not a natural storm. That was a storm directed to from the Most High himself to pass judgment on them wicked people. It says, no hearts can think upon these things worthy, and who is able to conceive his ways? It says, it is a tempest which no man can see, for the most part of his works are hid. What we just say? The tempest? Well, I was just talking about the storm. That is the work of the Lord. And most of his ways are hid. Because he's got the sun come up and the moon come up. He's got everything in his place. He got the waves of the ocean that holds his bounds. They stop where he told them to stop. These are the Lord's ways and his powerful works right in front of your face. But a lot of y'all don't even look at that and be in awe of the power of the Father, man. But that's all right, because we are in awe, brothers and sisters. We're going to go to the book of Job, chapter 9, verse 24. It's the book of Job, chapter 9, verse 24. Hey, Dave. Nothing much. It says, the earth is given into the hand of the wicked. That's right, the wicked people are running the earth right now. Remember all that stuff back in the 80s? When they talking about going, having a war on drugs? When the wicked were the one bringing the drugs in the first place, man? Huh? Just It's like that big ship that came into New York Harbor, and what they find, like 15 tons of cocaine, and they just let the people go. Didn't nobody go to jail for that, you know. They didn't seize the boat. They let the boat go. And that's why it says right here, the earth is given into the hand of the wicked. He covers the faces of the judges thereof. And the wicked, the same people that put up this false god of false god, this false image of Jesus Christ, he the one that covered up the images of our saints, the brown people that were ruling the earth at one point. Thou are the wicked. And it says, if not, where and who is he? So if you can't figure out who the wicked people are now, woe unto you, you're sad, man. Let's go back to the book of Revelation, chapter 14, verse 6. It says, and I saw another angel fly in the midst of heaven, having the everlasting gospel to preach unto them that dwell on earth, and to every nation and kindred and tongue and people. And that's what's happening now, man. We're preaching the gospel, man. We're preaching the true gospel of this Bible, saying with a loud voice, fear God and give glory to him, for the hour of his judgment is come, and worship him that made heaven and earth and the sea and the fountains of the waters, man. And that's what we're talking about, man. It's time to come back and worship the true creator of the universe, Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, man. It says, and there followed another angel saying, Babylon is fallen, it's fallen, that great city. And that's what we're speaking of now. These are future prophecies. Because the Lord is coming back and he's going to destroy this so-called filthy place called America that does nothing but corrupt the words of the Lord and blaspheme the name of the Lord and tell people they can do whatever they want and go against all law, statutes, and commandments of the Lord. This place is filthy and corrupt. It says, Babylon is fallen, that great city. Because she made all nations to drink of the wine of the wrath of her fornication. She made all the nations. And that's the same thing I was telling you about with them Chinese and Japanese people. You done succumbed to the ways of Babylon. That's why everybody wearing three-piece suits. And where's your beautiful garments, those Japanese and Chinese people? It says the third angel followed saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast and his image and receive the mark in his forehead, or in his hand, that is the RFID chip. Do not get this thing. The RFID chip is the mark of the beast. Do not get it. That's the mark of the beast. The RFID chip is the mark of the beast. That's why they say no man will be able to buy or sell with this thing. That's why they're trying to promote this cashless society. It's coming in. It's coming in soon, people. It says the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of God, which is poured out within without mixture unto the cup of his indignation. That's why we're telling y'all to repent and do not succumb to the ways of this world. Because his ways of the world are contrary to the ways of the Lord, man. And he shall be tormented with the fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb. Now when they say he shall be tormented, he's saying that the nuclear missiles are going to come and destroy America. So there is no hell, but the people are going to be left there in Babylon when the nuclear missiles come to destroy this place. All the people that are drunk of the cup of fornication. So they're not going to get saved like the rest of us with those chariots, man. Hopefully we're going to be saved. That's what we're working on now. We're doing all this work for the Lord to save us, man, to have faith and mercy. We're having faith in the Lord, hoping that he will have mercy on us. It says, and the smoke of their torment ascended up forever and ever, and they had no rest day or night who worshiped the beast and his image, and whosoever received the mark of his image. Here is the patience of the saints. Here are they that kept the commandments of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai. So these are the ones that kept the commandments of the Lord, and that's what we're trying to tell y'all. Okay, so we're going to stay in Revelation, but we're going to go to chapter 18. This is Revelation chapter 18, verse 4. It says, and I heard another another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people. That's what we're talking about, man. Choose none of her ways. Be holy. Be separate. Just go to work. Come home. Make your food. And praise the Lord, man. Read the Bible. Try to do what you can to stay on the up and up. Of course, you know, you're not going to be no hermit or nothing, but still. Just try to figure out what the Lord wants you to do and do it. And I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, and that ye receive not of her plagues. For her sins have reached up unto heaven, and God has remembered her iniquities. Reward her even as she rewarded you, and double unto her, double according to her works. In the cup which she had filled to her, double. That's right. So all that slavery she done did to the children of Israel, all the police shooting them in the back, all these just spitting in the face, oh, you can't drink out of this water fountain, all these things, do double to them. That's what's going to happen in the kingdom of heaven, man. So they're going to go in slavery. That's why I say, he that leaveth in captivity shall go in captivity. It says, how much she hath glorified herself and lived deliciously, so much torment and sorrow give her. For she said in her heart, I sit as a queen and am no widow and shall see no sorrow. Yeah, because America thinks it's untouchable. It thinks that it can go around and mess with all these other nations and ain't nothing gonna ever happen to it. I mean, the audacity of these people, when a soldier get killed, man, you in the middle of the war, but they're always making a big deal about some American soldier getting killed. That's what war is all about. But that's what it says right here. I sit a queen and am no widow and shall see no sorrow. So you think that nobody's supposed to shoot your men, even though you're over there in another country telling these people what to do with their own country, and you're shooting and killing them, but they can't kill your men. You're going to get all upset when they kill one of your people. What kind of stupidness is that? It says, therefore shall her plagues come in one day, death and mourning and famine, and she shall be utterly burned with fire, for strong is the Lord who judges her. Because the Lord is coming back to judge this wicked kingdom called America. All this stupidness they done did to the children of Israel. And it's over. It's almost over, man. Let's go to the book of Luke, chapter 17, verse 26. This is the book of Luke, chapter 17, verse 26. And as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be also in the days of the Son of Man. They did eat and drink. They married wives. They were given in marriage until the day that Noah entered into the ark, and the flood came and destroyed them all. So the Lord is saying, those are the words of the Messiah. He's saying, just like in the days of Noah, man. The Noah kept coming down there telling the people to repent and get themselves together. The time is at hand. The Lord don't like your wickedness, what you're doing. Doesn't that sound familiar? Isn't that what we're doing right now? But no, they're still down here partying every day and every night. They're not considering what we're saying. They're not considering what the words of the Lord are saying, asking them to repent before it's too late. So just like the days of Noah, when Noah walked in that ark, the flood came and killed all those people on the planet Earth, except for 8 people. And the same is going to happen to y'all folks around here. So we're just hoping to be in that number, man. Let's go to the book of 1 Colossians. I think that's Colossians, right?
Is that Corinthians? Probably 1 Corinthians.
Well, we're going to read this anyway. This is the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 1, verse 26. It says, for ye see your calling, brethren, how that not wise, many wise men after the flesh, not many mighty, not many noble are called. Because everybody's not called to understand this word, like I was talking to you about, brother. Not everybody's called to understand this word. They're going to think it's foolishness. It says, but has chosen the foolish things of the world to confound the wise. Because you got a lot of these scholars, these Bible thumpers, that think they know everything. But they just cannot accept that the Lord say, I don't care about them other nations. I only care about the children of Israel. So therefore, they won't accept the true word of the Lord. So they're blinded. He said he confounded the wise, and God has chosen the weak things of the world to confound the things which are mighty. Just like David and Goliath, for instance. You know what I'm saying? Just like instead of us being in some mega church preaching this true gospel of peace, we're on the corner. Now we're going to go to Colossians now. This is the book of Colossians, chapter 1, verse 26. It says, even the mystery which hath been hid from ages and from generations, but now is made manifest to his saints. That's right, because the mystery of the Bible has been hid from generations to generations, but now, in these last days, the Lord has opened up our eyes and he's opened the seals of the book. So therefore, we can now see and know that we are the lost 12 tribes of Israel, and we're coming out here to proclaim that. We're coming out here to proclaim the true Lord and Savior. His name is Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai. Okay? And we're coming out here to proclaim that we now know that we're the lost sheep of Israel because of the curses that befell us, that we went into slavery, and it's time for us to repent and understand that we went into all the slavery because there was a punishment for breaking the law, statutes, and commandments of the Lord. And we are sorry for doing that, man. We apologize to the Lord for doing that. So we can move forward now and be a better people. That's what we are here doing. Proclaiming that this so-called Jesus Christ is not the true Messiah, man. Okay? Let's go to the book of Hebrews, chapter 11:11. It says, through faith also Sarah herself received strength to conceive seed and was delivered of a child when she was past age because she judged him faithful who had promised. Therefore sprang there even of one and him as good as dead, so many as the stars of the sky in multitude and as the sand which is by the seashore innumerable. These all died in faith, and not having received the promises, but having seen them afar off, and were persuaded of them, and embraced them, and confessed that they were strangers and pilgrims on the earth, man. So that's what we're doing out here. We're standing out here in faith, man. Now let's go to Hebrews 11 and 1. It says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen, because We don't actually see what the Lord looks like, but we know by the scriptures of what it say he looked like, and we know it don't look like this false God named Jesus Christ. So that's where your faith comes in, to believe this, to believe the words more than these lies that they done told you up in these churches, man. It says, for by it the elders obtained a good report. Through faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai. So that things which are seen are not made of things which do appear. Okay? Let's go to the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 18. We're going to go to the Apocrypha. Oh, Okay, this is in the Apocrypha, Ecclesiastes chapter 18. It says, "He that liveth forever created all things in general. Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, only is righteous, and there is none other but He." Because there's only one God, man.
How you doing? Like tripping last night.
Yes, I know.
You know that, right?
Yeah, but hey.
And then look where the fuck you're
at. Let me read you something.
You gotta read this shit. Read yourself.
I'm gonna read it.
Read yourself.
I'm gonna read it. It says, this is Proverbs chapter 24, verse 16. It says, "For a just man falleth seven times and rises up again. But the wicked shall fall into mischief." So the wicked gonna continue to do wickedly over, they never gonna stop. But a justified man gonna jump back up on that damn horse and say, "Forgive me, Father Lord, for all the sins I committed." That's the difference between a justified man and a wicked man. I knew it was coming. Because we're not perfect, brothers and sisters. We're not perfect. But all we can do is repent and stay the course. He that endures to the end, right? It says, we're going to start back over. This is the Apocrypha, the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 18. It says, "He that liveth forever created all things in general. The Lord only is righteous, and there is none other but He, who governed the world with the palm of His hand, and all things obey His will, for He is Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, of all, by His power, dividing holy things among them from profane." So you divide holy things from the profane things, man. It says, "To whom hath He given power to declare His works, and who shall find out His noble acts?" Who's going to do this? His chosen people, man. "Who shall number the strength of His majesty, and who shall also tell out His mercies?" That would be us, man. That's why we're coming out here declaring His works before men. It says, "As for the wondrous works of the Lord, there may nothing be taken from them, neither may anything be put unto them, neither can the ground of them be found out." It says, "When a man hath done them, then he beginneth, and when he leaveth off, then he shall be doubtful." It says, "What is man, and whereto serveth he? What is his good, and what is his evil? The number of a man's days at the most are 100 years. As a drop of water unto the sea, and as a gravel stone in comparison of the sand, so are 1,000 years to the days of eternity. There is a God patient with them, and poured forth His mercy upon them." Because the Lord is merciful, man. That's why the gates of mercy are open right now for those that repent, man. Now, we're not talking about living in sin. Because what is that? That's iniquity. But hey, if you slip up, that's what the gates of mercy are for. To repent, man, and come back to the law, statute, and commandments of the Lord. Is this thing moving down? It says, he saw and perceived their end to be evil. Therefore, he multiplied his compassion. So he saw ahead of time that the children of Israel were going to be breaking all the laws, statutes, commandments, and everything. So he gave them a way out, man. You know what I'm saying? He sent his son to die for our sins, to give us grace, to turn and repent. That's his mercy, man. It says, "The mercy of man is toward his neighbor, but the mercy of the Lord is upon all flesh. He reproveth and nurtureth and teacheth and bringeth again as a shepherd his flock." That's beautiful. That's beautiful. Let's read that one more time. He said, "The mercy of man is toward his neighbor, but the mercy of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, is upon all flesh. He reproveth," that he correcteth, "and nurtureth and teacheth," man, "and bringeth again as a shepherd to his flock." That's it.
That's it, man. Now we're going to stay in Ecclesiastes, and we're going to go to 17. Chapter 17, verse 17.
Hey, what's up,
Dino? This is the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 17, verse 17. It says, "For in the divisions of the nations of the whole earth, he set a ruler over every people. But Israel is the Lord's portion." Because that's what we're talking about in the beginning. Because these people done lied to you about this so-called false god and false idol named Jesus Christ. But that's not our God. That is the Caucasian people's God. Because right here it says, because he said, now look at everybody in nations. Nations of people. So you got the Israelite nation, then you got the Caucasian people. That's their own nation. It says, "For in the division of the nations of the whole earth, he set a ruler over every people," right? But Israel is the Lord's portion. Israel belongs to the Lord, man. Whom, being his firstborn, he nourished with discipline, and given him the light of his love, doth not forsake him. Therefore, all their works are as the sum, are the sum before him, and his eyes are continually upon their ways. He's watching everything that we do, people. That's why it's good. That's why it's good for us to repent and come back to the Lord every chance, anytime we might stumble or fall down, man. It says none of their unrighteous deeds are hid from him, but all their sins are before the Lord. Just like you have a child, and you ask that child, "Did you do something wrong?" You want that child to tell you the truth, man. You don't want that child to lie. You know what I'm saying? So that's what the Lord wants. He don't want us to keep lying to us. He already know the truth. He just wants us to confess to us, to him, and turn back. Because if we confess our sins to him, that means they're not hidden no more. They're no more secrets. So that means we can throw them behind us now and move on. Okay? Let's go to the book of Romans, chapter 10. It says, "Brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, is that they might be saved." Who might be saved? The Israelites, man. It says, "For I bear them record that they have a zeal for God, but not according to knowledge." That's why you have a lot of people shouting in these churches, jumping up and down, talking about how much they love Jesus. They love Jesus. But the Lord said, "For I bear them record that they have a zeal for of God, but not according to knowledge." Because they love the Lord, but they're not. They loving this false God named Jesus Christ. Not Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, the one of this book, the one of this Bible. They give you laws, statutes, and commandments that you're supposed to adhere to. It says, For Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, it's the end of the law for righteousness to everyone that believeth." So when you believe in the Lord, the law become you, man, and you just choose to do what's right more than what's wrong. Okay? It says, "For Moses described the righteousness which is of the law, that the man which doeth those things shall live by them." That's why you should live by the law, to keep yourself in line. "But the righteousness which is of faith speaketh on this wise, say not in thine heart, who shall ascend into heaven, that is to bring Yahweh Shai down from above? Or who shall descend into the deep, that is to bring Yahweh Shai again from the dead? But what it said it, the word is nigh thee, even in thy mouth and in thy heart, that is the word of faith which we preach." So instead of you looking to the sky for Yahweh and looking down below for Yahweh, Yahweh is right here, man. He's in your heart, man, because it's in these words. And you live. You live by Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai. We wake up thinking about the Lord. We go to sleep thinking about the Lord. We eat. We pray over our food about the Lord. You know what I'm saying? We get home from being out in the streets all day. We thank the Lord for bringing us home safely, man. We live the Lord. Okay? "That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth that Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, and shall believe in thine heart that Yahweh hath raised
him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Because it goes again that a lot of people don't believe in the New Testament. For with the heart of man believed unto righteousness, and with the mouth confessed is made unto salvation. For the scripture said, whosoever believeth on him shall not be ashamed. And that's the power that we have right now to come out here and preach the gospel of peace, man. Because we're not ashamed of the true gospel of peace. We're not ashamed of the Lord. Actually, we're damn happy. Because this is the gospel, man, the good news. Telling us that, hey, yeah, y'all went into slavery, man. You know why? Because you're being punished. But that also tells us that we're the 12 tribes, the lost 12 tribes of Israel, man. And it also tells us that, hey, these people that's over you, that got their foot on your neck, they're going to get what's coming to them. Okay? So we're not ashamed of these things. Okay, for there is no difference between the Jew and the Greek, for the same Lord over all is rich unto all that call upon him. And now a lot of people don't know what this means, but it just means that the children of Israel back in the day were calling themselves Greeks because they had conformed to the ways of that world. They had been Hellenized. Just like you brothers and sisters are calling yourself American, African American, calling yourselves West Indians because you have the fallen away has happened to you. You don't know that you're the Israelites. So that's what he's talking about. Jew or Greek. For whosoever shall call upon the name of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai shall be saved. So how are you going to call on that name if you don't know what the name is? It says, how then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in him of whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher, man? It says, how shall they preach except they be sent? And as it is written, how beautiful are the feet of them that preach the gospel of peace and bring glad tidings of good things, man. But they have not all obeyed the gospel. For Isaiah said, Yahweh Shai, who hath delivered our report. So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. But I say, have they not heard? Yes, verily, their sound went into all the earth, and their words unto the ends of the world. But I say, did not Israel know? First Moses said, I will provoke you to jealousy by them that are no people, and by a foolish nation, I will anger you. That's right. But Isaiah is very bold and said, I was found in them that sought me not. I was made manifest unto them that asked not of me, after me. But to Israel, he said, all day long I have stretched forth my hand into a disobedient and gainsaying people. The Lord said, all day long he stretched forth his hand to Israel, man. Thank you. Night, y'all. Let's go to Revelation chapter 18. We're almost through, y'all. We got like three more scriptures to go, okay? Did we read this already? Just gonna go to 4. This is the book of Revelation, chapter 18, verse 1. And after these things, I saw another angel come down from heaven, saying, great power and having great power, and the earth was lightning and his glory. And he cried mightily with a strong voice, saying, Babylon the great is fallen, and has become the habitation of devils. And behold, of every foul spirit, and a cage of every unclean and hateful bird. For all nations have drunk of the wine of wrath of fornication, and the kings of the earth have committed fornication with her, and the merchants of the earth are waxed rich through the abundance of her delicacies. Rice. I can't, brother. Rice. I can't, I'm on a fast. We're going to go to the book of Isaiah, chapter 13. The burden of Babylon, which Isaiah the son of Amoz did see. It says, lift ye up a banner upon a high mountain, exalt the voice unto them, shake the hand that they may go into the gates of the noble. And that's what we're doing now. We're waving this banner, which is the Bible, proclaiming the words of this Bible so that it will go into the gates of the nobles. So that these elite will know that their time is at hand for all their wicked deeds they done did. All these Illuminati people running around here spreading all this wickedness upon the earth. And all these people that lied to the children of Israel and not telling them that we are the children of Israel, man. So this word is being published upon all the world. It says, I have commanded my sanctified ones. I have also called my mighty ones for mine anger, even them that rejoice in my highness. The noise of the multitude in the mountains, like as of all great people, a tremulous noise, the kingdom of the nations gathered together, and the Lord of hosts, most of the hosts of the battle. They come from a far country, from the end of heaven, even the Lord and the weapons of his indignation to destroy the whole land. And that's what I was showing that brother. Because the Lord is getting ready. He's got that over in Iran right now. If y'all didn't see it on YouTube, it says Iranian military versus the chariots of the Most High. Because you had a UFO fighting, just flying over the sky, and the Iranian military was just shooting their missiles at the UFO, man. Because the Lord is getting ready. He's showing his power. He's just it was just playing with those people. It says, "How ye, for the day of the Lord is at hand. It shall come as a destruction from the Almighty. Therefore shall all hands be faint, and every man's heart shall melt." That's how scared people gonna be, man. That's why we're afraid now, man. That's why we're not playing around. We're afraid of the Lord right now. We're trying to do what's right so the Lord will have mercy on us in that day. Let's go to the book of... Let's go to Revelation chapter 20, 21, verse 9. And this is going to be the last scripture of the night. Okay, y'all? This is the book of Revelation, chapter 21, verse 9. And there came unto me one of the seven angels, which had in the seven veils full of the seven last plagues, and talked with me, saying, "Come hither, and I will show thee the bride and the Lamb's wife." And he carried me away in the spirit to a great and high mountain, and showed me that great city, the holy Jerusalem, descending out of heaven from God, having the glory of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, and her light was like unto a stone most precious, even like a jasper stone, clear as crystal, and had a great wall and high, and had 12 gates, and at the 12 gates, and at the gates 12 angels, and the names written thereon, which are the names of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel. I just want to make that clear at the end, just to put a nail in the coffin of these churches with all their false doctrines and lies. They done lied on the Most High, lied to his children, telling them that everybody can be saved and everybody's going to heaven. But right then we just read that the angel came down showing the Jerusalem coming down with 12 gates, and on the name of the gates were the 12 tribes of Israel's name, man. Not everybody in the whole world. Not the Chinese people. Not the Japanese people. Not the Caucasian race. Nobody else. But the children of Israel. And all the other nations are going to be our servants under us, man. So with all that, I'm going to turn to the east and close it out. And give all honors and praises to Yahweh. Bahashem Yahweh Shai. Bahashem Rekakadah. Thank you, Lord, for letting me come out here again tonight. Keeping my head clear. You know what I'm saying? Not throwing me away. Thanks for letting me preach the gospel of peace, brother. I want to give double honor to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone for teaching this word in all truth and sincerity. Also want to give salutations to all the hopeful elect out there who's pushing the word just like I am. Just like I just showed that brother earlier in the video.
There was a live stream as well. I think that's Louisiana Camp. You know, that's out there pushing the word. They believe in 100% truth. And we're waiting patiently on the Father to return. And of course, the one-third, they believe in 100% truth. And we're doing everything we can, man, to stay afloat and to keep the faith until these last days. And may the Lord have mercy on us all. Okay? So with that, I want to say good night and amen. Close it out, brother.